Elon Musk and his companies have brought some of the most innovative methods in space exploration and on-road transportation to the world as a result of all the technological advancements we have witnessed in the last few decades. However, it is possible that the billionaire genius is not only staring at space and the Earth, but also the empire of the sky as well. The aviation industry has been the least progressive in recent decades, but this is not because human beings could not come up with better alternatives. Rather, it is because the alternatives would have unprecedented effects on either its financial viability or its environmental sustainability. But is it possible to respond to this with electricity? How does Tesla intend to proceed with one of its most ambitious projects, which is to take the flight quite literally to a new level of sophistication? My name is Alex, and I'd like to welcome you to another amazing video. We have little knowledge of what to expect from the Tesla plane, in contrast to Musk's automotive and interplanetary ambitions, so we will attempt to break down the video into four parts. What is Tesla's vision for the future of the aviation industry? Is it superior to a conventional plane? What are the issues at hand? Is it possible for Tesla to solve the problems associated with an all-electric plane? If you are a new subscriber to our channel, please make sure to click on the subscribe button. We have also included some bonus information about the Tesla plane at the end of this video, so be sure to watch it through to the end. What is Tesla's vision for the future of the aviation industry? Tesla is making strides in the field of on-road transportation. You can find thousands of videos and leaks about Tesla's innovations with their on-road EVs, but a Tesla plane appears to be something that would take an inordinate amount of time and would be unwise to put off for any length of time. Elon Musk, on the other hand, has stated that he is considering developing an efficient electric plane, which is in direct opposition to the above. Here's what he had to say in an interview: a better design. I mean, it's possible, I believe it is. We've talked about it, we've talked about it with our friends and girlfriends, etc. Some sort of electric vertical takeoff and landing supersonic jet or something of that nature would be the most exciting thing to do. What we can infer from the information is that Elon has stated on numerous occasions that his preferred design for the plane would be a VTOL, or, to put it another way, a craft that can take off vertically. Additionally, based on the interviews, he has confirmed that he intends to convert it into a supersonic jet. However, simply looking on the bright side of things does not suffice to convey how well it can perform. Another indication that Tesla is seriously considering this project is the fact that the company is looking into the enormous problems and developments that will be required. Elon claims that the inability to build a Tesla plane is not only a financial problem, but also a barrier to efficiency and the resources available to them. Although Tesla is attempting to build a full-capacity plane, there have been numerous studies and patents submitted by car manufacturing companies such as Tesla and Hyundai for a prototype of cars that could transport 3 to 4 people in the air. Because there are other companies besides Tesla that are investing in such technologies, it would provide the necessary competition for Tesla to present their best results as quickly as possible. Is it superior to a conventional plane? We are experiencing difficulties with our planes. Not a lack of innovation, but rather a lack of practicality and financial feasibility. To be more precise, take, for example, the Concorde, which, when it was first introduced in the 1980s, could complete a flight from New York to London in just 3.5 hours. However, even though this was a practical solution, it was fraught with difficulties, particularly in terms of fuel pricing and the potential harm it could cause to the ozone layer. Due to the fact that it flew twice as fast as the speed of sound, it was extremely noisy and necessitated extra caution during takeoff and landings. Because of these issues, the flight was abruptly terminated, and it appears that we have reached the end of the road in aviation unless we resort to using an electric plane. Electric planes run on batteries and can be significantly less expensive than conventional planes. In addition, we would save money on manufacturing costs and would avoid the ridiculously high maintenance costs associated with a traditional plane. According to Musk, he also intends to make takeoffs more efficient by shortening the distance between the runway and the aircraft. If the plane could generate upward thrust that could then be redirected as forwarding thrust for movement, the flight would be able to take off almost like a drone. Because the upward thrust can be divided between multiple propellers, it can be used to reduce the amount of noise produced during takeoff and landing. This is also a practical possibility, because the estimated power required for an aircraft to take off is only 400 watt-hours per kilogram of weight. Tesla is also working on increasing the capacity of its batteries. The Tesla plane, in contrast to conventional planes, would be supersonic and would not have the problems that we currently have. This means that transportation would be significantly faster, and the travel time could be reduced by approximately 50%. The issues at hand. When we talk about the Tesla planes, we can't forget about some of the obstacles that Tesla will have to overcome to make them a reality. The battery would be the most difficult aspect of flying an electric plane. This is something Elon Musk has mentioned numerous times as one of the most significant obstacles to the development of a Tesla airplane. Even though batteries are extremely powerful, they can only store a limited amount of energy. In contrast to fuels, which can be transported and transferred in a relatively short period of time, electricity cannot be transported or transferred at all. Tesla is working on increasing the capacity of their batteries, and according to Musk, there may be opportunities to develop more efficient batteries within a couple of years. A further issue is that flights are not permitted to make pit stops. Even if you have a fully charged battery in your Tesla car, you may need to stop for a break or two if you are traveling across the country. Imagine being able to fly hundreds of feet up in the air over multiple countries on a single foot. For those looking forward to the Tesla plane, the fact that multiple companies are working on ways to make batteries more efficient without increasing their size should be a welcome relief. However, it is not only the battery capacity that the airlines would have a problem with, there is also the issue of safety. Fuel tanks in a plane can have multiple safeguards in place to ensure that they do not become damaged, and even if they do become damaged, some steps can be taken to reduce the magnitude of the damage. However, because the electric plane is still in its very early stages, there is simply not enough research or certifications to be able to provide a protective protocol if something happens to the battery during flight. In addition, checking the battery for faults regularly is extremely expensive when compared to simply checking the fuel pipes on a traditional plane. While a conventional plane can dump fuel if something goes wrong during takeoff or landing to minimize explosive damages, there is no way to dump a battery out of the plane and away from passengers if a battery catches fire in a hybrid plane. Is it possible for Tesla to solve the problems associated with an all-electric plane? Almost all problems have a solution that can be found. Because we are intelligent creatures, we will devise solutions that are both efficient and simple as long as there is time. This is to be expected when it comes to Tesla. The difficulties associated with flying an electric plane are also not as severe. It has already been demonstrated that we can take off supersonic jets from a vertical takeoff. It is also possible that electric planes will be able to travel for short distances at a speed of lower than 40 kilometers per hour, but only for a limited period. Does that sentence ring a bell with you? Yes, that is exactly what people used to say about electric cars when they were slow and had poor mileage. Then Tesla came along and changed the world of electric automobiles forever. It is possible to do the same thing with planes. Musk has also stated that, in order to address the issues, he intends to combine the Tesla facilities with the aeronautical engineers from SpaceX. As a bonus, this will provide a much-needed educational resource for an electric plane that no other company currently possesses. He has also stated that the prototypes of flying cars are capable of being used in real-world situations. Furthermore, the most serious issues with batteries are being addressed daily. Not only do electric vehicles, EVs, require smaller, but more efficient batteries, but so do appliances and other technologies, and the effort to make efficient batteries is being studied from all aspects of every industry. Once the battery issues have been resolved, it will only be a matter of time before the first electric planes take to the skies are seen. Consider what the passage of time has done to computers. The computers of the 1980s were enormous, but they consumed a tremendous amount of power. It is now possible to have a computer that is as sleek as a MacBook, while still having unrivaled power when compared to older computers. The same pattern will eventually be observed in batteries as well, and it is only a matter of time. Tesla is also successful in providing an alternative to the current power source. Isn't it more practical if the plane could charge while in flight, rather than having to land and charge on the ground? There is, however, a solution, and it is known as solar power. Solar panels that are extremely efficient in terms of energy production could also serve as a backup power source for the Tesla plane, which would be as efficient as having a backup fuel tank on a conventional plane. Tesla will indeed have to completely rethink solar panels to achieve the highest efficiency, but this is doable, at least in theory. However, not all solutions for the EV plane come from Tesla. Some of the best ideas for the EV plane come from people who are concerned about the environment as well. There have been fundings and specific research conducted to produce efficient electric planes, and the best part is that these are available as open-source software. As stated by Kevin Nordker, the president and CEO of Ampere, we must make changes in the industry, and electrification is one of the major trends that will hopefully alleviate some of the burdens. We've arrived at the most important part of the video so far. Examine the distance between Tesla and the release of an electric plane, as well as the likelihood of such an event occurring. It is difficult to predict a specific launch date for the Tesla plane. However, scientific advancements in the field of electronic solutions, as well as Musk's enthusiasm for the project, can be used to estimate a rough time frame for when the product will be available. According to the researchers, based on the description, it is very likely that we will see a smaller and more efficient battery within 3 to 4 years. Did you like what you saw in our video? Would you be interested in flying in the Tesla plane when it becomes available? What are your thoughts on the Tesla airplane? Please share your thoughts in the comments section. And if you'd like to see more videos about electric vehicles, click on the